Today we're going to run MATLAB on the web for the first time in preparation for the EECS 1011 lab components. We go to our web browser and type in WebFAS URQ. The first link that comes up should be the Citrix Receiver web link. You may be prompted to install the Citrix Receiver software. You should do so. The download should take a few moments. Once it's downloaded, double-click on the downloaded file and follow the instructions from there. Typically, you'll have an installation file. Double-click on that. Agree and continue. Install it on your computer hard drive. You may be prompted for your administration password on your local computer. Once it's done, go back to your web browser, click on continue, and use your York University passport login and password to log into WebFAS. At this point, you can now add an application to WebFAS. Hit the plus. Go to All Apps and choose MATLAB R2015A. So that's the 2015 release of MATLAB. On some web browsers, a download will occur, and you'll have to click on the downloaded file. In other web browsers, you can simply double-click or single-click on the icon and MATLAB will load up. Here you're being told to wait for the application as it starts. Here is the opening window for MATLAB. And soon we'll have the main window for MATLAB show up. Here we go. MATLAB is very good for doing plots of data. And so we'll start with that. Start typing in plot and open parenthesis. Oh, before we continue there, we need to change the keyboard from French Canadian to US English. So back to plotting. So plot and open parenthesis. Open square brackets, and now we're going to put in 10 different numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Close the square bracket, comma, open a square bracket, and we'll put another 10 digits in. And it can be any 10 digits you want. Got 8 digits, 8 numbers. Let's put in 9 and 10. Close the square bracket, close the parenthesis, put a semicolon in, and hit enter. Depending on your web browser, you may have a warning here about graphics. Just be patient. And figure should show up in a moment. There we go, here's your figure. It has plotted pairs of numbers based on your first set of data and your second set of data. We have data that represents the horizontal and data that represents the vertical. So the first set of data was your horizontal, second set of data was your vertical. Let's do it again. Plot, open parenthesis, open square bracket. We'll put 10 numbers in. So 1 through 10. Close the square bracket, comma, open square bracket, and we'll just put another set of 10 numbers. So 100, 200, 300, 400, etc. We need 10 of them. and close the square bracket. Comma, and now we'll do something different. We're going to tell MATLAB that we want the individual data points to be represented by circles. So we put single quote O dash single quote close parenthesis semicolon. And now we have another plot that has the same line going through it, but this time every individual pair of data, horizontal and vertical, is represented by a circle. And there you have it. That was your first figure, or your second figure, I'm sorry. And now we're going to put in a title. And the title is, this is my super plot. So title, open parenthesis, single quote, this is my super plot, single quote, close parenthesis, semicolon. And now we're going to put a label on the horizontal or x-axis. So we type in x label, open parenthesis, single quote, this is the x-axis. Typically you want to have units. So we'll say these are my units. Then single quote, close the parenthesis, semicolon, and we'll do the same for the vertical axis. Y label, open parenthesis, single quote, this is the Y axis. Close that with a single quote, close parenthesis, semicolon. Now go looking for your figure, and here we go. It has a title. It has an X axis or horizontal label, and a Y axis or vertical label. There you have it. This is your first MATLAB plotting exercise. We'll be doing much more of this later.